episode 2249, Where Your Heart Burns Bright.
Moms, needing a little inspiration and a ray of hope? You've come to the right place. This is the show that you can turn to for just the pick-me-up you need. This is Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive.
Happy, happy day. I pray that you're making space in your day for God. It is Sweet Spirit Sunday. It's a time of reflection as to where you are moving with God in your life. I know sometimes we get stuck in all of the stuff that we have to do, but we have to really stop and ponder where your heart burns bright. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com, where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. But when you make room in your everyday for God, it's there where your heart burns bright. Matthew chapter 6, verse 21 says this, "For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also." So what do you treasure? I don't think that's a question we ask very often, except for when we are attacked with a Bible verse. And yes, I say attacked because we get defensive as to what we think we're doing right when we think somebody else sees us as doing wrong. But you see, most of us are so busy and caught up in the world that we tend to leave God behind. I really want you to search your heart today. This is not about throwing darts. This is about reflection. And I come to you with this because I too have this reflection. Yet if you look over the last week, what activities and actions were you committed to? If I was to look at your calendar, I've looked at mine. If you looked at your calendar, what would jump up? Would it show anything? Are there any reminders on there that says, hey, have you talked to God today? This is just a peek into what you treasure, what matters to you. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. But for some reason, it's easy for us as Christians to get too laid back into our daily interaction with God. Just because we've accepted Jesus Christ as our personal Savior doesn't mean that we got it all put together. In fact, we leave a lot on the table. A heart burning bright. Or is it? And that's the thing. God wants to be at our everyday table. He doesn't just want to show up for the important events like weddings and births and deaths, Christmas and Easter. God wants to sit at your table every day. He wants to know what matters to you. He wants to hear your hurts. He wants to heal your wounds. He wants to love you. God's treasure is in us. So he holds us in his heart. But what about us? Do you treasure your relationship with God enough to make time for him in your everyday? You know, my daughter and grandson are in town this weekend, and as my son-in-law is away. And for dinner, we decided last night that the family wanted pizza. So off we went to get the pizza. Well, guess what? Everyone else had the same idea. And I went and placed my order. Yes, no, I did not do an app and order in advance. I like to go and order in person. That's just me. Call me old-fashioned. That's fine. But that's what I like to do. Well, I ordered it, and she said, you have a 40-minute wait. And I was like, oh, okay, it will definitely be fresh. I said, that is fine. I'm patient. I'm happy to wait. Well, you know, some people wouldn't think about bringing God to buy pizza. But last night, I did. Because there were a lot of people, customers that walked in that weren't very nice. They were flustered because something that should be ready when they walk in the door within 30 seconds of ordering and paying for it, they should be able to walk out with whatever they ordered. But there was a wait. There was a delay. There was no immediate gratification. When I walked up to this sweet young girl, I could tell she was flustered. I could tell in her moment she was carrying the weight of the world It was a lot of pizza and breadsticks and buffalo wings and sauces. And so I took time and I showed the workers grace and compassion. I encouraged them by acknowledging their hard work. I said, thank you, multiple times. In fact, the gal that actually took my order said, well, I hope they make it, but I'll be leaving in 10 minutes. Guess what? She gave me my order when it was complete. She didn't leave. Where do you think her heart was? In serving me. So what can I give her? A taste of God, a taste of compassion, a taste of grace. Not an attitude of I'm entitled, not an attitude of why don't you have your life put together, not an attitude of you're wasting my time, an attitude of love and support. You see, I was acknowledging their hard work, but what they didn't see directly was my heart. Yet at the same time, I was there to do what? To get the pizza. But it wasn't about the pizza. It was about where my heart shines bright, and that's with God. They got a taste of that compassion. Where here, my family got a taste of pizza. Life isn't always what we see, but who God places in our paths. Look beyond what you can see and be ready to share the treasure of God's love and grace. Where your heart burns bright, that's where your treasure will be found. So I ask you today to ponder and reflect. What is in your heart? And what is that treasure? Go out, have a blessed week. Be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a beautiful day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.